ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ. ಐ ಆಮ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಮನೋರಮಾ, ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಪಾಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ನೂಪುರ ಭ್ರಮರಿ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಷನ್, ವೆಲ್ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಯು ಆಲ್ ಟು ದ ಶೋಧ ಸರಣಿ. ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದ ಸಕ್ಸಸ್ಫುಲ್ ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಶ್ರವಣ ಸರಣಿ, ಆನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪರ್ಟ್ ಲೆಕ್ಚರ್ ಸೀರೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ಆಡಿಟರಿ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಹೆಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ 2020, ವಿ ನೂಪುರ ಭ್ರಮರಿ, the reputed institute of Karnataka for qualitative research and writing, have now come up with another series, Shodha Sarani, an art research series. This series is dedicated to all kinds of performing arts, including allied art forms. Our aim is to encourage, promote qualitative research and help in the upcoming studies by establishing the productive research to the art fraternity. This week, Srimati Rashmi Krishna Thapar from Bangalore presenting her research work on lighting. Welcome to Rashmi Thapar. Over to Rashmi.
ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ. ಐಮ್ ರಶ್ಮಿ ಥಾಪರ್, ಪಿ ಎಚ್ ಡಿ ರಿಸರ್ಚ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ ಅಟ್ ಜೈನ್ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಬ್ಯಾಂಗಲೋರ್. ಐ ಎಮ್ ವರ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ದ ಗೈಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಶೋಭಾ ಶಶಿಕುಮಾರ್. ಐ ಟೇಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆಪರ್ಚುನಿಟಿ ಟು ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮೈ ರಿಸರ್ಚ್ ಪೇಪರ್, ಲೈಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಪ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೇಜ್ ಜರ್ನಿ ಥ್ರೂ ದ ಏಜಸ್. ಲೈಟ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ರೋಲ್ ಇನ್ ಡೇ ಟು ಡೇ ಲೈಫ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ನೋ ಎಕ್ಸೆಪ್ಷನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಪರ್ಫಾರ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಟ್ಸ್. ಇಮ್ಯಾಜಿನ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ರೂಮ್ ವಿತ್ ನೋ ಲೈಟ್, ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಸೀ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್. ನೌ ವಿ ಟರ್ನ್ ಆನ್ ಅ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಬಲ್ಬ್, ದೆನ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಫೋಕಸ್ ವುಡ್ ಬಿ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ದ ಏರಿಯಾ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಮಿಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಬಲ್ಬ್. Now we turn on another light, the focus would widen, and then we turn on one more. What seemed to be sober with minimum lights would now look brighter, and this is exactly what happened if we look back into the history of stage lightings. The journey from lamp as a source of light to modern equipment has seen varied changes over the years. The advent of technology in the 21st century has led to many innovations with regard to stage lightings in performing arts. History of Indian theatre. India, the land of rich culture and heritage, has a long history with regard to different art forms, most of which are in practice even now. However, gathering information about the exact time period of the birth of these art forms and how they flourished is a task by itself. One reason is the non-availability or the limited availability of the documentation. For this reason, it's observed that many historians or the scholars, they attribute them as either traditional, folk and contemporary, or as Maga and Desi. The elements of drama are found in Vedas, which means that the theatre existed much before the Vedic period. In 5th century BC, the Sanskrit grammarian Panini, he speaks about the Natasutras. Natashastra, a treatise on drama, gives a detailed picture about the classical theatre. As time passed, different scholars, historians hailing from different school of thoughts either propagated the existing or they surprised their contemporaries with their innovations. The Sanskrit language has a rich repertoire of plays scripted by Ashwaghosha, Bhasa, Kalidasa, Bhavabhuti and others. The Rupaka tradition slowly transitioned into the Uparupaka tradition. These Uparupakas then passed on to regional dance dramas like Yakshagana, Bhagavata Nataka, Kathakali, Krishnattam, Yatras and so on in Sanskrit as well as in the local native languages, which have thus preserved the tradition of theatres.
Treatises, evidences on stage lighting. According to Natyashastra, the ancient Indian theatres were well equipped, and the chapter 3 describes how the stage is lit brightly and the lamp is taken around the entire stage before the commencement of the performance. Also, as per Indra's instruction, when all the deities were assigned jobs to take care of the theatre during the performances, so were the sun and the moon. But metamorphically speaking, sun and the moon being the prime source of light, it would not be wrong to consider them as a natural source of light for the performance as well. Bharata describes the whole hall must be richly decorated with woodwork representing the creepers, birds, animals and so on. Another evidence from the theatre built at Ikkari by King Venkatappa in accordance to Shiva Tattva Ratnakara of Basavaraja mentions that the theatre was worked in ivory and sandal inlaid with precious stones. The theatre used to be surrounded by garden in order to receive enough light. Also, artificial lighting arrangements were made in the darker portions of the theatre, and the entire theatre was beautified with paintings of various themes on the wall, which looked just like a mirror. The Sangeeta Chudamani, an unpublished work on the music, also describes that there should be thick and beautiful curtains in the front and also at the back. In the works of Samarangana Sutradhara of King Bhoja, he talks in length about the architecture. He says the halls for the Prekshika and Sangeeta should be decorated with pictures of the damsels with the gladdened face expressions and the skillful dances. In Narada Shilpa, the work by Narada, he talks about the decoration of the theatre and says that on the top along the turret, beautiful figures of Gandharvas must be carved. Another evidence from the Tamil literature, Silapadikaram, speaks not just about the light, but also its arrangement. It says the light must be placed such that the shadow of the pillars must not be cast on the king or his party or even on the spectators. Silapadikaram says that the stage must have painted canopy above and the pearl hanging along with other garlands which must beautify the stage. As Bharata mentions that the stage and audience hall must be beautified with carvings and paintings, similarly all these texts gives us enough evidences about the beautification of stage that adds more beauty when the natural lights fall on them. Well, all these evidences give us an idea about the existence of a well-built theatre in ancient India.
Kodiyattam. Just like any other theatre forms of India, there are different opinions by different scholars on the exact time period of the origin of Kodiyattam. They say the art form originated during the ruling period of Sri Kulashekara in and around 10th century AD. He, along with his Brahmin scholar Tulan from his kingdom, are known to be the initiators of this art form. And the proof for the same are the two important works of Sri Kulashekara which are enacted in Kodiyattam style. There is another evidence which is found in the Tamil literature Silapadikaram of 5th century AD, which talks about the Chakyar Kootu, which is a solo representation of an actor. This also gives us an idea that the form was in practice much before the 10th century AD.
Natya Mantapa and the aesthetics of stage lights for the performances then and now. Kootambalam, a dedicated place for Kodiyattam or the Kootu performance. Though the performing area is a raised platform, yet the distance between the actor and the spectator is less, unlike the current proscenium stage. The place stands out for its architectural beauty, aesthetic ambience and ritualistic significance. The Kootambalams are designed such that the shadow doesn't fall on the audience. Kodiyattam is one of the oldest living traditional theatres, following the ritualistic process, in turn blending the aesthetics and poetics in the performance. One of the important factors of the Kodiyattam performance is the presentation itself. An elaborated performance for days together actually happens as per the ritualistic process. In earlier days, this form was restricted to be performed in the temple premises by the Chakyar and the Nambiar community. However, since a few years, we can witness the performance outside the temple area, due to which the art form has gained popularity outside Kerala too. Nilavilakku, or the lamp, is an important stage property for any performance in Kerala. It is the lamp that leads the performance. They believe it is absolutely okay if there are no audience, but the presence of lamp is a must because lamp is considered to be auspicious and the performance is done for happiness of the divine who resides in the lamp. Nilavilakku is a long metal lamp approximately 4 feet to 4.5 feet which can hold up to 3 liters of coconut oil. 3 wicks are connected to the lamp and each wick has a significance. While it is said that each wick symbolizes the Trinity, Brahma, Vishnu and Maheshwara, whereas few opinionated that it refers to the actor, Chakyar and the Nangyar, and some mention it as a 3 fires of Yagashala. The only source of light in a Kodiyattam performance is via the lamp. Here, while one wick faces the audience, the other two faces the actor during the performance. This way, they ensure to cover more of the actor's facial expression. This led to a question: if the light was actually enough to ensure the visibility of artist. The interviewees mentioned that the Kootambalams are small spaces inside the temple premises which can accommodate very small audience ranging 25 to 50 members only. The distance between the performing and the audience area is also quite less, due to which visibility isn't an issue. This gave another realization that the only source of light for the night performance during those days was the organic and the natural way. Even the eyes of the spectators used to get adjusted to the light as and when it slowly dipped, unlike today's state of being exposed to bright lights. However, in the little wider spaces, in addition, two diyas are hung at the top facing the actor in order to shed more light for the performance. Creating an effect on the stage is an artistic liberty which all artists strive for. In spite of minimal lights being used for the performance, yet special scenes and special entries are filled with effects with then available materials. Kootu Vilakku and Pandu were the special lights that are in vogue even now. Kootu Vilakku is fixed to the rods and is held by two persons on either side during the character entry. It uses oil and the wick to burn the flame. Pandu are the stick torches wherein the upper portion of the stick is wrapped in cloth, dipped in oil and burnt to produce the flame. The sticks are held by the helpers on both the sides while the special characters enter. While in recent times we make use of smoke to create an effect, however, in Kodiyattam, the usage of telli powder, which is a dried pine resin powder, is an add-on in creating a dramatic effect to the spectators. As the powder is splashed on the flames, it sizzles, thus giving a magical look during the character entries. It is also believed that the organic matter in the powder would cleanse the air around. This whole dramatic effect creates an illusion of the real.
Stage lightings after the advent of electricity. It's a known fact that Kutumbilams are restricted for the performances of the Chakyar and the Nangyar communities, due to which many other community artists moved out of the temple to perform. This led to the performances happening in the outside arena, like the open air, proscenium stages and so on. With the advent of electricity, the changes were not just witnessed in the social life, but a lot of changes were observed in the performing arts as well, and Kodiyattam was no exception. When the Kodiyattam performances are staged in certain auditorium or even abroad, the interviews mentioned that they were supposed to use certain modern lights that was been available in the auditorium. However, they avoided the usage of the color lights, the spotlights and some of the fancy lights that are being used in the auditoriums.
An interesting discussion which Sri Ramit Ramesh, who is a graduate from Kalamandalam and also has exposure at ITI Intercultural Theatre Institute at Singapore, said that he had an opportunity to learn the contemporary approaches. This is where he understood and experimented the usage of stage lighting in Kodiyattam without hindering the aesthetic value of the art form. While he shared his experience, as there was a restriction in using fire flames on stage at Singapore, he created an illusion of the light as if it was emitted from the lamp placed at the center. He says that this was possible only because of modern lights, which otherwise wouldn't have worked. He's also experimented in using spotlights at different angles and creating different types of shadows on stage. We'll now watch a video by Sri Ramit Ramesh, which will help us to understand how the modern lights are being incorporated without hindering the aesthetic value of the art form. Similar lines, Sri Rajneesh Chakyar, belonging to the Chakyar community, shared his experience. During one of the performances in Rome, the character was supposed to enter through the audience with the helpers holding the fire torches. Since the auditorium did not permit the use of fire flames, the light designer helped them in creating an illusion of fire torches using LED lights. When they also performed abroad, the small bulbs replaced the fire flames in the Nilavilakku was one of his fine experience where he appreciated the usage of modern lights. Being in line with the above artists, the other interviewee is Kalamandalam Krishnendu, who is a Kodiyattam and Nangyar Kootu artist, Srimati Meera Nangyar, Nangyar Kootu artist, Sri Sajit Vijayan, who is a Marwu and Chakyar Kootu artist. They believe that the modern stage lighting can add benefits to the performance, provided it is used in a restricted manner without harming the aesthetics of the performance.
Bharata's significant gift to the Indian theatre is the rasa. And he also mentions how Rasulpati leads to Rasanishpati. It is impossible to separate the art and the aesthetics because the presentation loses its meaning without the rasa. Any experimentation into the dancing traditions must see the beauty that underlies in all of its components. Thus, one should be adequately equipped in all the aspects that go into the form and also the ability to figure out its beauty and joy that it gives to the Rasika. Folk theatre tradition. The term Desi is connected with the nature, which in turn connects to the rural inhabitants. Looking back into the history, a community celebration, cultural practices, or the celebration of divine is what that brought people together, and it was the means of entertainment. However, with the Western influence, a demarcation between the classical and the folk came in, which otherwise was the Marga and the Desi. Not all the folk art forms, which were once said to be an open-air play, or the theatre, or the dance, are seen even now, because the art has moved to the platform as that of the classical theatre or the dance. So whether we refer to them as the classical or not is still debatable. Nevertheless, folklore is a tradition which has been passed from generation to generation, which has thus kept it alive till late. Yakshagana. This old drama tradition of South Karnataka, mainly prevalent in coastal and the hilly Malnad region, is a beautiful combination of music, dance and literature. The performances were popularly known as Bayalata. Finding its roots strongly in both Telugu as well as the Kannada literature, it is difficult to ascertain the exact time period. They made use of classical literary forms in order to spread their message of devotion and spread it across the eastern Livingston part of Karnataka as Moodala Paya Yakshagana and Padolo Paya Yakshagana.
Stage lightings in Yakshagana then and now. During the no electricity period, it was the natural lights that served the purpose for any art performances. The morning presentations made use of sunlight, whereas the night performances were staged in the presence of cool moonlight and the stars being a natural backdrop for the performance along with the light from the fire flames. Yakshagana, also known as Bayalata, was initially staged in the paddy fields between dusk to dawn. The early periods of presentation made use of dondi or divatike, which were fixed at the corners of the stage. Well, the stage was just a paddy field with a demarcation of bamboo sticks at the four corners. The area inside this was the presentation zone. Though the light emitted from the dondi or the divatike was not as bright, yet as it was a night performance, the entire area around was dark, because of which the presentation area seemed bright in the presence of torchlight. This brightness is also termed as Manda Belaku in Kannada. The expansion of artistic creativity. In order to create an effect to the special characters in the performances, they made use of additional torchlights. There would be helpers who would carry extra torchlights in their hand on either side to create a grand effect of the character entry. Here, the helpers move in accordance with the character as well. This would increase not just the visibility of the face, body and costume, but also highlights the Abhinaya portrayed by the character. To make it all the more dramatic, they also throw a powder known as a Rala Pudi on the flames, which just creates a bright sparkle highlighting the entry of the special. Later, as the innovations emerged, Petromax or the gas lights started replacing the fire torches where these gas lights were hung from the top of the bamboo pole. The gas lights managed to emit much brighter light from the former. However, every 30 minutes it had to be pumped to increase the flame. It is to be noted that the Yakshagana performance, the makeup was supposed to be made in the torch lights only, because this would ensure to maintain the same amount of brightness of the face on the stage as well.
With the invention of electricity, bulbs and tube lights grabbed all the attention. Now, unlike earlier days, not just the Rangasthala was bright, but the entire area around the Rangasthala was bright, and this became a kind of attraction for all the audience. Though this period found a gradual decrease in the usage of divatike, yet as a mark of auspiciousness, the performances would begin with a divatike entry and then the divatike was placed at the side of the Rangasthala. However, during this time period, the critics completely opposed the performances in the presence of tube lights, because the light emitted is much brighter to the eyes and the focus would be the lights and not the character. In terms of aesthetics, it can be said that the makeup and the costumes of Yakshaganas is well appreciated with the dim orangish and the reddish lights, and the usage of tube lights would definitely make the entire performance flat and thus failing to create an earthly feeling which was once witnessed. As the time progressed during the commercialization of Yakshagana, the Rangasthala was replaced by the wooden floor, the open air theatre was now the proscenium stage, and the free shows were now ticketed. All these changes forced the team to think in the aspects of marketing and attracting the audience for the performance. This is when the modern stage lighting became important. Many technological equipment now enter the presentation. Floodlights, LED lights, moving lights, flickering lights, and colors started seeing their space in the performances now. Dr. K. M. Raghavan Nambiar, he says the use of these torches gives one the feeling of a full moonlight. These torches were placed all around the stage to give a uniform lighting throughout the performance. This lighting transports one into a different world, and he says in 1963 and 64, Yakshagana was staged using the tube lights. Dr. Shivaram Karan, eminent writer and Yakshagana scholar, made a strong case for Yakshagana performances to happen with Devadiki. These oil-soaked torches would give an earthy effect to the stage, which had a starlit sky as a natural backdrop. Even when the torches burnt out, one after the other, when the oil dries, the remaining torches were sufficient for watching the play, since the viewers' eyes were gradually adjusted to the fading lights.
Veteran Yakshagana artist Professor M. Lakshminarayan Samaga, he agrees to the usage of modern lights, but within the limits only. He says the light should not take away the character, but should only support the character. Also, he feels it is very important for the light technicians to have enough knowledge in lights and the history of the corresponding performing art so that he can maintain the aesthetics of the art even with the usage of modern lights. Another veteran artist, Sri Kirimani Shivananda Hegde, he would still prefer to go back to the usage of fire torches or minimal lights because he feels that these lights bring out the caliber of an artist, especially his Angika, Vajika and Satvika. But now, the grandeur of modern lights has camouflaged the actor's Abhinaya. He prefers to avoid the technical dependencies as it directly affects the actor's capability in the performance. In the documentary, Discoveries in Yakshagana, Dr. Raghavan Nambiar says it is absolutely difficult to bring in complete darkness as it was before in the Devatike performance. Though Devatike performance initially seemed dark, gradually the eyes would get adjusted to view the image of an actor and invokes the imagination level of an audience, thus creating a different world, which is the intent of Yakshagana. It is noteworthy that Yakshagana held sway for many centuries in Karnataka and reached its peak during the rule of Mummadi Krishnaraja Vodiyar in early 19th century. Ali Lingaraj, a scholar in Mummadi's court, wrote more than 40 Yakshagana prasangas, which were staged across the princely state.
In earlier days, the source of light was either the natural light or the five flames, because of which the eyes were adjusted accordingly. But in the current times, since everyone is exposed to the brighter lights, it is definitely challenging for one to go back to the dim lights as before. Also, if you look into the present state auditorium, either in India or in abroad, the present auditoriums do not allow the usage of the fire flames, so which is also one of the reasons that one needs to use the modern stage lightings. However, aesthetically speaking, the current modern lights can add value to the performance because Yakshagana being strong in the Rasa Abhinaya, it is definitely possible to highlight the character using the modern stage lightings, but enough care should be taken by the light designer in order to strike a balance to portray what is just needed and not making it a light show. Traditional puppetry. It would not be wrong to say that the Bayalata performance eventually gave rise to many art forms, which were the means of entertainment, and one among them is the traditional puppetry. Though it is termed in different names across different states, the tradition of performing the epic and the mythological stories remains the same. However, in the contemporary times, we see that the social themes are also being presented. Puppetries are of string, shadow, rod, and the hand puppetry, and the study shall focus on understanding the string and the shadow puppetries with respect to the stage lightings.
Stage lightings, then and now, for shadow puppetry across southern India. Shadow puppetry is a popular art form presented across different states. This art form is known as Tollu Bommalata in Andhra Pradesh, Tolpava Kootu in Kerala, Togalu Gombeyatta in Karnataka, and Tolpave Kootu in Tamil Nadu. Across the above states, usually, in earlier days, the skin of animals, deer, goat, or buffalo were used to make the puppets, and the natural vegetable dyes were used mostly to color the puppets. The green, red, and the black colors were mostly used because the puppets were shown through the oil lamps. With the invention of electricity, sober chemical color shades came into use. However, it needs to be noted that even now in Kerala, the tradition continues to be performed inside the temple where they still use oil lamps only. Puppetry enactment is an interesting aspect of this art form because, unlike the huge spaces required in other art, this doesn't need such vast space. Nevertheless, the aesthetics of this presentation is to create an interesting space within the available small area. To stage a performance, a white curtain, which is a cotton cloth, is tied across the sides of the bamboo stick, where the lower and the back portion of the screen is covered with black or any dark colors, and the artist stands behind the screen. As the name suggests, the contribution of stage lighting is huge in shadow puppet. It is absolutely vital to maintain total darkness outside the stage, so that it gives an ethereal experience when the color shadow of the puppets emerge on the screen. In earlier days, it was mostly an oil-filled container with a cotton wick, which was used as a primary source of illumination. The container was refilled on a regular basis. Later, the usage of Petromax was the trend, followed by the electric bulbs and the focus lights. As a matter of fact, a lot of innovation went across lighting the stage differently. A realization in order to create an illusion of the reality is a reason behind this enormous growth. While some organizations happily embrace the change, whereas few prefer to continue and follow the earlier tradition. Here is one company which actively innovates and has never failed to impress their audience with the grandeur of stage lighting in their performances. The founder of Dhatu Puppet Theatre, Srimati Anupama Hosikere, says, "It is a light that creates a magic in the puppet shows because lights are used as a part of Satvika, which in turn helps in creating the rasa." They have a well-designed theatre comprising of all different types of lights such as miniature spotlights, LED lights, focus lights, smoke, cloud machine and so on. Their productions make use of enormous stage lightings. One of the recent creation, Ramayana, staged at Udupi used 150 lights. While she recalls as how lighting became a necessity as they could recreate many instances in their productions just by using stage lightings thoughtfully, which otherwise would have not been able to make it as interesting as it came out to be. Another interesting comment was when she said, "It is mandate for the puppeteer to have the knowledge of stage lighting, unlike just being limited to the designer," which is very true, as the exposure towards understanding the usage or lights in the artistic perspective is very limited across many art forms.
Puppetry art is widely practiced across North and South India, which are traditionally linked to the ritual context. However, the enormous growth is now well accepted and appreciated, which has started seeing its ways as a professional theatre too. It's heartening to know that many families across the country are continuing the art of traditional puppetry in spite of it not being a lucrative profession. Professional theatre groups. The earliest Kannada play found is Mitra Vinda Govinda by Singararya, who was in the court of Chikkadevaraja during 1700s. Later, the momentum picked up during the 19th century with a good number of plays based on mythology being written and staged by Sri Baswappa Shastri, Sri Aya Shastri, Sri Keluru Vasudevacharya, to name a few. Dating back to 1875 AD, it was the Marathi and the Parsi professional theatres who gave impetus to the local theatre companies to adopt the latest technology when they staged the dramas in the old Mysore area. Dazzling screen backdrops and colourful pyrotechnics were used in order to create different effects on the stage. In the year 1901, it was Konurkar Kada Siddheshwara Sangeeta Nataka Mandali, which was established by Sri Shivamurthy Swami, who used a power generator to run uninterrupted electric lights on stage, thus giving a contemporary touch to the Kannada theatre.
Gubbi Company, one of the famous theatre companies of Karnataka, their productions were managed with small kerosene lamps during their initial days. As days passed, the same kerosene lamps acquired a new shape, which were made to suspend from the cans in front of the ground. Special lighting was provided using coloured matchsticks. An interesting way of adding colours to the stage in their production was by using a water dimmer. Water dimmer was in use until 1957, where a pot was partly filled with water and salt. Two iron rods connected to the small wheel are suspended on it. When the wheel turns, one rod moves up and the other goes down, which affects the density of light. One rod is connected to the positive of the mains and the other to the negative, and each rod is connected to the light by the wires, thus creating a dimmer effect. However, an improved version of dimmer was replaced in 1960. This proves how innovation was added in order to create the effects to showcase a performance and how important these effects mattered for the success of the production. Igappa Hegadeya Vivaha Prahasana was the first drama in Havyak Brahmin Kannada dialect written by Suri Venkatramana Shastri in the year 1887. Though there isn't any reference about when it was staged, yet this was a socially relevant play written for the amateurs. This led to the growth of modern theatres and amateur drama troupes. The famous among them was ADA of Bangalore, LDA Kalavidaru of Mysore, Kala Mandali of Dharwad, and so on. It was during the 1930s that amateur companies came into existence. Since professional drama groups were too melodrama type, the amateurs had influence of Western theatres, due to which modern Kannada theatres began. Writers like Sri Adya Rangacharya and T.P. Kailasam pursued higher education in England. They experienced modern theatres over there and came back to Karnataka to come up with many socially relevant plays. Prabhat Kalavidaru. The famous theatre-based company in Bangalore was founded by Sri Gopinath Das during 1930s. They produced and performed many musical ballads with rich recorded music and special light effects. Cinderella, Punyakoti, Mohini Bhasmasura are some of their most popular productions. Sri Raghavendra J. Prabhat from Prabhat family proudly says that it was the Prabhat team who first started using the floodlights. Observing the kind of lights that were used in cinemas, they imported the spotlights from abroad and started using them for their plays. He says the production Cinderella in 1977 used enormous lights, approximately 200 lights were used, and they had also started experimenting on UV lights. They started creating the cloud and rain effect, color effect, and so on using stage lightings, which otherwise was impossible to create this illusion on stage. It was the Prabhat again who started using white screen as a background, which we call as cyclorama now. Usually, other teams use the painted curtains or so, whereas Prabhat chose to use plain white screen so that different effects of colors can be thrown on the screen for different scenes. The team believes and focuses on suggestive lighting in order to create a grandeur and magical effect in the presentation. Sri Rajendra T.D., who also belongs to the Prabhat Kalavidaru family, says, as a child, he used to be awed at the grandeur of the dramas put up by the company. Rich stage design, amazing lights and costumes were something that fascinated him, and that's why he enjoyed working at the backstage. It is noteworthy that the Prabhat Kalavidaru trained and also groomed light and sound technicians among their troupe members itself. The quest for the growth led to many inventions and innovations which benefited the art forms. During the 1970s, the Kannada amateur theatre had a sort of revival when, apart from the plays of Adya Rangacharya and Kailasam, new plays by Girish Karnad, P. Lankesh, Chandrasekhara Kambara and others were staged by a new crop of directors like B.V. Karanth, M.S. Satyu, Shri Prasanna, C.R. Simha, Shri Nagesh, Shri B.V. Rajaram, Shri Nagabharana and others. In the modern amateur plays, light played a subtle yet important role since the stage setup was minimal and lights were used to bring out the essence of the characters and the theme in a better way. Kelu Janamejaya, Sattavara Neralu, Hamlet, Othello, Oedipus, Kakanakote, Sankramana were some of the path-breaking amateur plays of those days. While most of the present-day amateur dramas are staged in proscenium stage, when the theme and story demands the open-air stage, the directors go for it. Malegalalli Madhumagalu, a play placed on the novel of the same name by Kuvempu, is a prime example of this trend. Mayasandra Krishna Prasad, a senior theatre person who worked in the famed Mysore Rangayana, says, lighting up a vast expanse of open stage in sync with the scenes being enacted calls for a great technical skill. This play, when staged by Rangayana at Mysore, had four stages with separate lighting setups with individual control panels. The beauty of this play was that the artist used panju or dondi in certain sequences to bring authentic feel of the bygone era of Malnad.
The journey to understand various aspects of stage lighting has been very thought-provoking, and the exploration led to the understanding that minimal importance was given to stage lighting as the focus was the performance only. Also, lighting was just a simple means of illumination. From using the natural lights emitted by the sun, moon and the stars, the art and the technique of lighting up the stage has come a long way. The last 100 years especially, after the introduction of electric lights, there has been a sea change in using lights as a part of Aharya. The Indian theatre groups were also influenced by the Western ballet theatre productions, which use stage lightings on a big scale to make it aesthetically pleasing. An art gains its value when it has been appreciated, and the end goal of an art is to invoke the feelings in the Saradhya. Theatre is a part of several subcomponents like the theme, literature, music, costumes, makeup, stage, and so on, which synthesizes itself as a whole to form a single component. Though performance takes the center stage, it is the subcomponents that plays an equal role for the work to be appreciated. When these are visualized individually, in an aesthetic angle, each turns out to be a main component adhering to the aesthetic principles to showcase the best version of it. Light, by its very nature, itself tends to be aesthetic. Light is the one which enables us to see and appreciate beautiful things of the world. Hence, there is a close relationship between the light and the aesthetics. Based on the analysis, it could be said that the stage lighting has a tremendous impact on the performing arts. One can incorporate stage lighting in order to create an ambience and to give a feel to the particular situation. Stage lighting itself is a creative art, aesthetic by nature, and it is the creativity of a designer to make the presentation successful, because stage lighting has the capacity to enhance or to mar a production. Yet, it is needless to say that the stage lighting has impacted to a great extent in enhancing the aesthetic appeal of the stage productions across all the genres of performing arts. I would like to thank Nupura Bhramari for giving me this opportunity to present my research paper. I'm very grateful to my guide, Dr. Shobha Shashikumar, who has always been a constant support. And finally, I would like to thank all the interviewees and my friends who have helped me out in this study. Namaskar.
Neat and clear presentation of the data and analysis. However, the examples serving as evidences to the analysis could have a bigger scope. Rather than seeming case study of limited variables, a bigger number of variables could have been covered, the focus of the presentation being a historical perspective by Dr. Shobha Shashikumar. The presentation is very neat and the data collected is useful. The work throws light on the evolution of the usage of lights in different theatre productions in India across space and time. The topic has great potential for exploration in many dimensions. For instance, the researcher can think of pointing out the manner in which different coloured lights, angles and shadows work as vyanjaka samagri in bolstering the rasa. As a corollary, it can also be pointed out how employing inadequate lighting can hamper the evoking of rasa. Additionally, what colors can amplify, which of the sthayi bhavas can be discussed. Modern techniques such as programmed lights versus manually operated lights can be compared. These are just a few possibilities. A broader cross-section can be taken for data collection, and also many of the modern theatrical productions can be analyzed for the said purpose. It was a pleasure watching the presentation by Arjun Bharadwaj. Rashmi traced the journey of the Indian stage lighting very beautifully. For the given period of time, she has dealt with a few dance forms in detail. She took up a classical theatre, a folk theatre, puppetry and modern stage drama. She mentioned how the artists had adjusted the modern day lighting to give the effect of an ancient illumination. There are many failures before a success. Understanding the failures will make sure it is not repeated. Failed experimentations, experience of people who failed could have been added to give a different perspective. Nevertheless, a great presentation with many insights. Congratulations, Rashmi and Nupura Bhramari, for creating yet another platform for upcoming researchers by Dr. Dwarita Bishwanatha.